Hi everyone, Zach here with Cornerstone Solutions. Today I'm going to do a follow-up video to a previous video that I did on creating multi-option proposals in Zoho CRM. Had a lot of people comment and ask how we send those proposals out, how people were able to choose one of the options. So today I'm going to show you how we as a company send out our proposals. Let's take a look. Okay, so if you remember from our last video, we had modified the deal module to contain our proposal, and then we had created a subform in here to manage all the different proposal items. And each one of them has an option, so option A, B, and C. We also created a template, a mail merge template for our proposal here. And this mail merge template will populate with all the different items that are in each one of these options that we choose. So we're going to take it one step further today, and we're going to add fields in for Zoho Sign. Zoho Sign is how we send out these proposals and how we collect what option that the person chose and allows them to sign the document. So I'm going to come down here to the bottom of my document, put my cursor down here. And I'm going to come over here to the left-hand side, and I'm going to choose fields. And then I have dynamic fields, and we see signer fields here. I'm going to choose signer fields. And these are all the different fields that are available through Zoho Sign to add into my document. And this is directly related to Zoho Sign. So Zoho Sign understands what each of these fields are when you add them to the document and you send it out through Zoho Sign. It understands the type of data that you're looking for when you choose one of these options. So I need three checkboxes. I need a checkbox for A, B, and C, and then I'm going to add a signature line in as well. So I'm going to choose the checkbox option here, and you can see that it adds a little green checkbox down at the bottom here. And then I'm just going to call this option A. And then we're going to do the same thing with B and C as well. Okay, then I'm going to add a signature line in here. I'm going to put my cursor right above the signature line, and I'm going to choose the signature field. Select that. I'll add that in there. Of course, you're going to want to dress up the document, make it all look nice, but this is just kind of basic, showing you how to add these checkboxes in. You can add other information if you want to. Some people may want to have a full name field where the person who's signing the document enters their full name, or have a sign date, or have them enter company information, things like that. You can definitely add all these things in. We're just going to keep it simple today. And now that I have these fields entered in here, I'm just going to click the Done button. And that's going to close the tab. Okay. So again, I mentioned that we use Zoho Sign to send these out, but I'm in CRM right now. And so you're wondering, okay, can I send these out from CRM since I have the mail merge document here? The answer is yes. The first thing that you want to do is you want to make sure that the Zoho Sign extension is set up in your CRM. And so you're going to come to setup. You're going to go to the marketplace and click on Zoho. And down here at the bottom, you'll see the Zoho Sign extension. I already have it installed here, but if you don't have it installed, you can go ahead and install the extension. Once it's installed, you can see a list of all the modules that it connects with. And so these are all modules that get either added to the system. There's some Zoho Sign specific modules that get added. And then there's some functionality that gets added in things like the sales orders, leads, purchase orders, all these other modules down here are modules that there's a button that gets installed where you can send the document out through that module. So this is great. The deal module is one of the modules that we can send from. That's where we have our proposal. So I'm going to go ahead and go back to my deal module here, and I'm going to choose my proposal. And you see that up here in the top right-hand corner, I have a Send with Zoho Sign button, which is great. I'm going to go ahead and click on that. Okay, so we have a little pop-up here. It asks us to select the document that we want to use. So I have a couple different options. I have Add Document and Use Template. In the Add Document section, you can add a document from your desktop. You can add, if it's in the CRM attachments, you can add it from the CRM attachments. There's a cloud import that allows you to import from like Zoho Work Drive or Google Drive, other cloud drives. Today, we're going to use the use template because we have this template art created in the mail merge templates. So I'm going to go ahead and choose use template and then mail merge template. And then I'm going to select the proposal template that we have. And go ahead and hit create. Okay, so it's attached now. In the recipient section here, there's a couple of different options. If you have an email field on this record, it will identify the email field and it will allow you to send out to the email address that's on the record. In this case, we have a related record, the contact module, that we could also choose here. In this particular case, I'm just going to choose the email, and that allows me to just enter a static email address. Okay, now the fields that we entered in on the template are only for one recipient. Now you can add multiple recipients into a template. Say you need two different people in a company to sign. You need the CEO and you need the COO to sign off on the document. You can add different fields for multiple recipients. We'll do that in another video. We're just gonna keep it simple today. Because I only have one recipient, I only need to set the signing for one recipient here. I only need to add one recipient into this. And so this is good the way it is. There's some more settings down here about how long the document is valid. If you want to send out reminders, you can leave a note. I'm just going to leave that blank for right now. And we're going to click next. Okay, so this is kind of a review page here. It's just going over what we've done already. So it has the document here. I can see in the next step here, I'll be able to see what's actually merged in, but I can kind of see that the fields have actually merged into the document here. It just kind of goes over what I've put in already. I'm just going to hit continue. Okay, and so I can see here that all the information from the different options has merged into the document. And I have that on the screen here. And then if I scroll down to the bottom, I can see my different options. And I can see as I hover over these that these are smart fields. The Zoho Sign recognizes these fields as checkboxes. I scroll down further, I see my signature line. Again, I can kind of hover over it and see that it recognizes this as a signature line field. And another way that I can verify that, when I hit the send button, it's going to pop up with this little window just verifying, hey, there are four fields on this document that people can fill out. That's great. I'm going to go ahead and confirm this and send this out. Okay, so our document is sent through Zoho Sign, and somebody will get that in their email. They'll be able to choose an option. They'll be able to sign the document. And then, of course, I get notified when they get signed, and it comes back and everything's great. Okay. There's one other thing, and we're going to do this in a separate video. As an organization, you know, a lot of times when somebody signs the document, you're going to go into your CRM and you're going to mark the deal as closed one. You're going to put some information in there. And there's a manual process that happens after that. And so we as an organization created an automation that when somebody signs the document in Zoho Sign, that it automatically gets attached back to the deal record and it updates the stage in the deal record. And then we have a field that actually updates what proposal option that they chose. And so it's a really great automation. It saves your salespeople a little bit of time in having to manually enter that information to the system. Most people, you know, when the proposal is signed, that's the deal being closed and that's an indication, but you can create automations. We're going to do that in step three of this video series. And so we'll go through and show you how to create that automation to automatically mark the stage as closed one, things like that. So I hope this video has been helpful for you today, showing you how to use Zoho Sign to collect information in a proposal, like what option that they want to choose, get signatures, and send that out through the CRM. Have a great day. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.